I've not even started the video and I'm about to cry. This is unbelievable. Hey guys, welcome back to my YouTube channel. If you're new to my channel, you've not come across this beautiful face, where have you been? Consider subscribing and just to tell you guys what's been happening. And right now I'm actually at university and I'm so grateful because it's actually a testimony. It all started last year, 2018, when I applied to university and I got accepted. To go to university, like, you have to go to the campus to collect your ID card. So when I went to university to collect my ID card, yeah, they said, oh, Nora, unfortunately, we can't let you register. Can't let you register on this course because you owe us £2,500. Sorry, can you repeat that again? Because I'm sure I didn't hear you properly. You said, Nora, on our system, it's showing us that you owe us £2,500 because you applied with you applied to come to this university back in 2016, but because you withdraw, you have to pay the fees. So I asked this lady, so what happens if I don't pay the money? She said, oh, we can't accept you onto the course then. And this is what this lady told me. I'm not lying. If I'm lying, let thunder strike me. This lady told me that, no, she was like, Nora, if you don't pay us this money, no university in the UK will accept you. And I was like, that is some bullshit. I'm sorry, but I don't swear that much, but this was unbelievable. Unbelievable. Like, I couldn't believe it. I absolutely could not believe it. So basically what happened was, guys, in 2016 I did apply to the university, but I had to withdraw from the course. Due to some personal reasons, I didn't want to go to that university anymore. You know, I didn't want to do that course anymore. This is for my university students. Open your ears, open your ears. You know, when you start university in September, you have to, like, October. If not, then you can switch to another course without having to pay any fees. But because I later on withdraw from that course in November, which was past the deadline was supposed to be in October. When I got accepted onto that course in September, I never attended any classes, any lectures. So why am I being charged for something that I didn't even come to do? They were like, oh, that's none of our business, whether you were attending lectures or not, you have to pay the money. Can we negotiate something yet? I was like, I am 22 years old. Why do you think, as we speak right now, that I'm going to get £2,500 to give you guys? They were like, Nora, there's nothing else we can do. So I even tried to negotiate with these guys that, okay, is it possible for me to pay the money little by little? So, like, to set up like a direct debit. So every single month I'll be paying a certain amount of money. While I'm on the course, they say, oh no, you have to pay the full amount of money. I'm like, Jesus Christ, this is unbelievable. I called my mom. My mom was like, which money? Which money, Nora? Which money are they talking about? You know what? I'm coming to that university. I said, Jesus, I'm finished. I am finished. So I went to Manchester to meet my parents and I explained to them everything. My mom looked at me. She said, Nora, do you know the country you are in? So according to you, money grows on trees. So according to you, we'll just remove £2,500 and just dash like that without finding out a solution. They said, no, we need a second opinion. We need a second opinion. We wanted to take this issue further, like, you know, take it to court. And this whole court issue thing is not something that would take 1 week, 1 month. It's something that is a process. It could take a long time, you know. You know, let's see what else we can do about it. While we were trying to find a solicitor, I called another university. It's always good to get a second opinion about something if you're not sure. So I called another university and I tried to explain to them what was happening. This other university, they were like, what? That's not true, because every university have their own policy. Will not affect you applying to this university. I said, the devil is a liar. Guys, bear in mind that this happened in September last year. And I waited until October, November to call this other university. And I even asked them, because there was a course I was interested in, I said, is it too late to apply for this course? They were like, yes, Nora. If you would have called us in October, we could have at least considered your application, but it's too late. So what do you have to do? Wait till September 2019. Throughout this whole period, guys, I was just so upset and angry. From September to August, I was just working and raising the £2,500 at the university. We're saying that if I don't have the money, they cannot accept me. I applied to another university. This was Coventry University. And I got accepted. I applied through Clearing in August. Guys, I went there for an interview. The same day, they said, Nora, we would love to offer you a place. And we can't wait to see you in September. I said, God, you are good. It's not finished. This was in August. So my course is due to start on the 16th of September. September was approaching and I've not received a call from Coventry University saying that Nora, you have to come and register, you know, to collect your card. I called Coventry. I was like, hi, my name is Nora. I came there for an interview for this course and you guys offered me the course, but I need to know when I can come and collect my ID. They were like, we are still reviewing your application. I was like, no, I'm sorry, but I think you're talking to the wrong person. Review my application. I've already been there for the interview and they've offered me a place. I have an email confirmation. What the hell? What do you mean you review my application? You know when you're so angry sometimes, eh? You can even curse somebody. I said, devil, not today. And we're still considering your application because you did not meet the entry requirements. I said, the devil is a liar. I came there for that interview and it was even the manager of this course that interviewed me. He saw my certificate. He said, Nora, even though you don't have all the entry requirements, we are still going to accept you. Put me on the phone to that person that interviewed me. I need to have a word with them. Guys, at this point, I was so frustrated. I prayed to God. I don't even know why I'm about to cry. That day, guys, I prayed to God and I said to God that, God, if this year goes by without me going to university, I'm never ever going to university again. I don't care what happens, I'm never ever going to university. And I called my mom and I told her, Mom, if this year 2019 goes by and I'm not starting university, I'm never ever going because I've tried everything. So guys, while all of this was going on, I was very depressed. No, I didn't want to have contact with anybody. I just completely shut everything down. I didn't want to speak to friends or families. I was just reserved to myself. And I was so angry that I was very aggressive towards people. Uni is supposed to start on the 16th of September and it's the 12th of September. I've not heard anything from Coventry University. I guess this is the end, you know, there's nothing you can do about it. Maybe this is all God's plan. Maybe you were never meant to go to university. That evening before we went to bed, we did pray. Important, you know, but sometimes it is difficult to pray, especially when you're going through hard times, and especially when something that you expected to happen so soon. And the date is approaching, but nothing is happening. It's very difficult to pray. I lost all hope in God. I was even doubting that, does God even exist? But that evening before we went to bed, my mom was praying. My mom told God that, no, enough is enough. You need to do something. Guys, I also told my pastor about this. I made a final call to the university. Breakdown, I started crying. It was even my mom that took over. My mom started talking to them, like, what's happening? Like, we need to know. What have you guys finally decided? Do you still want to accept my daughter? My mom told me to stop crying, that I need to be strong. And she gave the phone to me and I spoke to them. And I was like, what's happening? Like, what did you guys finally decide? Because university is due to start like in less than 4 days. I need to know. So that after my application and they've decided to give me a place, I was still happy, but I knew that wasn't over because the final step was for me to go and collect that ID card. This woman lied to me. I feel like everything happens for a reason. Maybe there was a reason why God didn't want me to go to that university. You know, sometimes when you feel like all hope is gone, that's when God surprises you. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video and you also feel inspired. And I also want to say thank you so much to everyone who checked up on me, to see how I was doing. I mean, God bless you guys so much. Like, it really means a lot to me. But yeah, you guys are amazing and I love you guys so much. Thanks for watching. Bye.